survivors of child and sexual abuse. What information do elders have that they've been holding for decades about child and sexual abuse that we're not even thinking about them as a vital like resource to use that information to use that with children? It's like circular, you know, indigenous is all circular. You know, like how we have to be thinking outside of the boxes that we've created inside these institutions when we have these catchphrases and stuff, because I understand that these things start for a particular reason of that time, but we're in a different time now. So, you know, when we say no means no, okay, I understand how that started. That doesn't pertain right now. Like, we need to change that, because sometimes we don't have the voice to say no. But just because we didn't say it doesn't mean that our body is not telling you we don't want this to happen, right? Again, it's on us. So I think about the marginal, it is like, it's even the way we think, the way we like made it into this little compact thing. If we do this, then we can help our children. Don't talk to strangers. If anything ever happens to you, tell me. Mm-hmm. Adults can't even tell people. Support parents, people in their lives, they can talk to them. But it's just not, I mean, that's not simple for anybody to do. So we really have to think about this process, and we need to think about not just sex education. I talk about it as holistic sexuality information because it is holistic. We have reduced sex to penis and vagina, marriage and love. And what I'm doing is exploding that shit. And it is way bigger than that. It is way bigger than just sex. It is about how we freaking communicate with one another, how I see someone and show, see their humanity, how all of these things. So all of that has to do with how we actually succeed, how we succeed in life. So to me, this is more than just CSA prevention. This is about how do we have our children succeed in life, because that's all about information. It's about storytelling. It's about me sharing with my own child all of my hardships and all of the beauty, so that she could get all of my information and then use that for herself, and she could fall or rise with it, because it's her choice and she has to make these decisions, right? So when I think of that marginal, it is first and foremost children. And I can get into trans people, I can get into being a survivor that was raped and assaulted as a girl, and then being a trans individual who's fluid, and how that kind of shapes when we are trying to heal for access spaces that are only for women. And so I've been denied over and over because